Hello, I'm Dr. Amna Jaj from medicalvisual.com, and today we are going to have a review lecture on the topic of implantation. So let's begin. As we have already discussed, the zygote, that is, it is formed by the fusion of the male and the female pronuclei, and it is surrounded by the zona pellucida and the coronal radiator cells. Both this male and female pronuclei, they have 23 chromosomes. They duplicate, arrange themselves on the metaphase plate, and then they undergo the process of mitosis. And this specialized mitosis, in which the daughter cells are almost the half the size of the parent cells, it is called cleavage. Their growth is limited by the presence of the zona pellucida layer. And then these cells, they also undergo the process of the cleavage. Initially, the zygote is surrounded by the zona pellucida as well as the coronal radiator cells. These cells, these are called blastomeres. At about 2 cell stage or 4 cell stage, coronal radiator cells, it is dissolved. And the cells that are tightly packed, they develop intercellular connection. In this process, it is called compaction. At about 16 cell stage, this beautiful early embryo, it resembles this mulberry fruit. That's why it is also called marula. The early embryo, it travels from the uterine tube towards the uterus with the help of the ciliary action of cilia that are present inside the uterine tube. And now this early embryo, it is welcomed inside the uterine cavity by this nutritious fluid that is called uterine milk. These cells that are present at the periphery, they have specialized sodium channels that allow the influx of the sodium, and the water follows the sodium, and it results in the formation of the cavity inside these cells, and the zona pellucida disintegrates. And now these cells, they proliferate and arrange themselves in a specialized fashion by forming this cavity that we call the blastocele, this inner cell mass that we call embryoblast, and the peripheral cell or outer cell mass, we call them trophoblast. And this pole of the embryo that is having the inner cell mass, it is called embryonic pole, and the opposite is called abembryonic pole. And the early embryo at this stage, it is called blastocyst. Now it is ready for implantation. Let's have a closer view. Now this early embryo, it loosely attaches with the endometrium with the help of these selective molecules. And there is a formation of specialized polyhedral decidual cells that are filled with the glycogen. And also the glands of the endometrium, they also deepen. And these changes that are very marked on the presence of the embryo, these are called decidual reactions. Now this embryo, it binds tightly by the help of this fibronectin and integrin relationship. Now the cells that are close to the endometrium, they arrange themselves in a specialized way that they lose their cell membrane and they form a syncytium. And now it is called syncytiotrophoblast. And this outer cellular layer is called cytotrophoblast. And now the syncytiotrophoblast, they invaginate and results in the early implantation. Now this happy endometrium, it will send a happy message in the form of HCG to the corpus luteum. So that corpus luteum proliferates, then it becomes corpus luteum gravidititis, and it secretes a lot of progesterone in order to prevent the shedding of the endometrium. This early embryo, it also secretes the early pregnancy factor that can be detected as early as about 36 to 48 hours. Actually, at about 4 cell stage, this early embryo, it stimulates the ovary that produces the early pregnancy factor. But later on, the embryo produces its own EPF. Both this EPF and the HCG, they are immunosuppressive, and they prevent the rejection of the embryo, as its genetic makeup is very different from that of the mothers. Thank you so much for watching this video.